If you have not already viewed my Introduction to Sword Spinning video, please click the link here. It goes over some important information that will help you become more efficient as you learn the sword spinning technique. The most important thing that you should know is that this part of your hand will never leave the sword right here. So the spin, the two will always be connected right there. So if you find your hand slipping off or the sword moving like this, you know you're doing it wrong. It will always stay just like this in your hand. Maybe at one point it'll just be stuck between your forefinger and thumb, but it won't ever leave here. So that's the most important thing that you need to remember why you do this spin. The first step is to simply lower the sword point toward the floor. So you're essentially stretching this part of your wrist right here. So do that a couple of times. The next step is as you go down, you're gonna turn the sword. So go down and kind of turn it so that way your palm is up. And remember, this part of your hand never leaves the sword. So point the sword down, turn, and palm up. So if you do that a couple times, it'll look like this. Here's from another angle. Down, turn, palm. So once you got that down, the next step is right here. You're gonna put your palm out, the heel of your hand. You're gonna kind of thrust it out. So you start from the beginning, you go down, turn, palm, and then thrust the heel of your hand out. And once you're here, you're just kind of gonna flip the sword up. Now as you do this part, the momentum here is gonna help you with this. If you do it slow, you're using a lot of the muscles in your thumb, which might be uncomfortable. So once you get that part, you can do it faster and use the momentum to help you. But for now, go slow, step by step. And remember, this part of your hand does not leave the sword. So you're gonna point down, turn, palm up, thrust the heel, and then launch the sword up. So it's gonna look something like this, slowly at first. You can see a lot of the time I'm just holding on with my thumb and forefinger. I'm just kind of pressing the sword into that part of my hand. Once you get that, you can go a little faster. If you find yourself slipping up, just go step by step again, start over. Down, turn, palm, thrust, and launch. And just continue that cycle. It's just one of those things where you just gotta keep on doing it until it kind of clicks. And once you get it once, you'll be able to keep on doing it. And then, like riding a bike, you probably won't forget. And eventually, when you get really good, you can go faster. But for now, just go slow until it clicks. And once you've got it, then you can just kind of, you know, spin the sword. Here's from another angle. So you're gonna point, turn, palm, thrust, launch. And remember, that part of your hand does not leave the sword. And you just gotta wait for it to click in. And once you got it, then you got it. I'll go over briefly how to do it in your left hand, just in case you're left-handed and you're having trouble with your right hand. So it's essentially the same exact thing, just in your other hand. And once you get it, you can go really fast. So I'll go step by step again, really briefly though. So you're gonna point it down, turn, palm, heel, launch. So really slow, step by step like this. And once again, this part of your hand doesn't leave the sword. So once you got the steps down, then you just kind of go for it, wait for it to click in. And once you get it once, then you're good to go. Here's some other angle. Down, turn, palm, heel, thrust. Just like that. So it's essentially the same thing, just in case you're left-handed. If you master it in your right hand, you can try in your left hand. It might take some practice, but once you get both hands, it'll be twice as cool. So you can try that, wait for it to click in, and then you're good to go. Once you've mastered spinning the sword, you can do all sorts of other cool tricks and moves. For example, starting in a ready stance, you can show off to your opponent, or you can impress your friends. If you want to try something more challenging, you can use different swords. Try a longer one or a thicker one, switch to your left hand, go back and forth. But once it clicks, you can do all sorts of neat things with the sword. And essentially, you just go spinning crazy. So I hope this tutorial helped you, and good luck in your future sword technique skills.